Hello friends, every year at the beginning of the Adobe Max, Adobe drops the biggest update to most of its CC products. Photoshop, Camera Raw and Lightroom are definitely a big part of that. In this video, you will watch the new features in Photoshop, Lightroom and Camera Raw. I will bring more videos step by step in the details. First in this series, first you will see the biggest feature in Photoshop are improved object selection and improved interop with the Illustrator. It is easier than ever to move between Illustrator and Photoshop, easily import vector content with the color, stroke and properties, as well as import layer structure and vector masks. Let's watch first with object selection. I am opening first time new Photoshop CC 2022 October release. It opened with the new colorful graphics and it opened with my recent edited images in the welcome page. I am opening that image with the loads of objects. It is actually a group picture of products. First, I am selecting an object selection tool from the tool panel. When you choose the object selection tool, Photoshop automatically analyzes the image using AI and decide which objects can be extracted. It takes some time. As I am rolling over different objects, a blue silhouette will appear over them. You simply click and a selection will be created around the object. This is different than the select subject button, because this new method can identify and isolate many different objects in an image. Now I am using shortcut Ctrl plus J in Windows or Command plus J in the Mac to duplicate the selection, so you can see how the selection was made by the new AI object selection. It did pretty good job with the selection except the little complicated areas. I am refining the selection, but it is not working. By mistake, I selected the duplicate layer, so tool is not working. I am selecting again the original layer with the object selection tool. I am refining the selection by using lasso tool by changing scale to lasso from the top option bar and adding selection on those area those was not selected. I used lasso tool over the silk ribbon to make proper selection. Now it was selected perfectly. After that, little refining the selection of aroma candle by quick selection tool. After refining the selection, I am using again shortcut Ctrl plus J in Windows or Command plus J in the Mac to duplicate the selection, so you can see how the selection was made after little adjustments. I am checking now whole selection will be selected the objects with the new object finder, so I am unselecting the object finder from the top option bar and selecting the single box by object selection tool. The object selection tool selected the same area as I was selected with the object finder. The ribbon was not selected here also, as the same with the object finder. So it did a great job with the sharp edge objects, but how it will work with the people? So I am opening a picture of a woman and selecting again object finder, but it selected only woman and ignored the another object of the cookie plate. I think it will be select the both. So I don't understand why it leave the other object. You can select the plate by adding object selection as a single object, and you can unselect it by subtracting the selection. Now I am refining the selection. And click on select and mask on the top option bar. You can see selection is good, but as far as concern of the hair, it did bad job. So lots of hair was not selected properly. Here I am refining here with the refine hair option and using refine edge brush. I am doing quickly. Here you can take your time to refine hair. After refining, selecting new layer with the mask and click OK. Selection is good except the little hair issue. So I am using white brush to reveal the missing part. I am experimenting with the another picture with more complicated hair. Let's see what will be the result. I am repeating the same steps, and in this picture, new object finder did not select the all objects as far as concern of the woman. Object finder failed to select here, as it select in the subject selection. I am unselecting the object finder and selecting woman as a single object with the object selection tool. You can see without object finder, it did pretty good job and most of the hair parts are selected. In summary, this feature is useful with the sharp edge objects. It needs more improvement on the part of the people. As far as a product photographer, it is a very useful feature in Photoshop editing. In portrait photography, I will select subject selection without object finder. Now come to the second update, and that is an improved interop with the Illustrator. Illustrator and Photoshop allows you to enjoy interactivity and easily bring AI files with the layers, vector shapes and path and vector mask in Photoshop that you can continue to edit and work with. When we open any EPS or Illustrator image in Photoshop, it opens a single layer. As I am opening here, you can see the all layered images are opening in the single layer. I am opening an image in Adobe Illustrator and selecting a group image from the document. I am pasting in new document of the Photoshop. It is a very small size image, so increasing its size and copy it again and creating a new document in Photoshop. Photoshop already set the document size according to the copied image size that was stored in the clipboard. As I pasted the image, a small window pop up with the loads of options, and first is layer. As I selected layers, in the layer panel, a group was created. Under this group, all layers are grouped in different subgroups. You can see them by hiding or unhiding groups. So you can edit layers according to your requirements. You can change color of any layer by creating selection of each layer. The second option is small object. With this option, image will be pasted as a small object document. So when you click on the smart object layer, it will open in the Illustrator, so you can also edit there. If you select pixel, then it copy as an image according to the pixels. If you select path, only paths will be copy on the layer. So you can edit any of the path by the pen tool. That's all for the today. Soon I will come with the more updates of the Photoshop. Thanks for watching.